the band, but now it's the new band called
Chasing the Skyline.
Chasing the Skyline. And I've done that with my eyes. Every city I go to, I chase the skyline.
It's just Toronto, always, it seems.
Oh, I can close. There's Toronto. I know that city like the back of my hand. Well, hang on a second. There's Montreal. Hang on. New York. Oh, where'd those towers go? Who knows?
And if you left us in Montreal, we'd have a couple. Montreal.
Oh, I love. I used to get drunk on Pine Street and stag around with a shot of tequila. And they're like, it's 3 o'clock, let's go in here. And then they still like, you're not a cop? No, I'm not a cop. Here, tequila. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. Who's got tequila? And no problems. You wake up, you know, noon, going, oh, bagels.
Tell people to look for us down there.
Tell people to look for you. But we have a lot of people that listen to the Road Dog Show from Montreal that I've connected with a few of the radio stations there and stuff. They listen in here, and I listen to them. They listen to me. We listen and go, you know, I like that band that I was talking to. Oh, I like that band that you were talking to. You know, all that.
I think I see them throwing up in
the street. Oh, yeah, they were there partying. They were on St. Catherine Street. I saw them. They were on René Lévesque to a boulevard one day. They were drinking and smoking and acting foolish. Anyhow.
That sounds like me.
Well, just, right. You know what I can say to you guys, okay? You know, you're going to be dumb. You're going to be stupid, just like all of us guys have been. Just moderation. Be safe, not sorry, because if you want to keep, if someone does happen to throw the keys of rock and roll in your lap, as Gene Simmons would say and has said, don't be foolish with it. Because when an opportunity knocks like that, if you screw with it, you'll lose it.
Well, if someone like Gene Simmons were to throw the keys of rock and roll in our laps, I think we would all be on our knees saying, show us the way, we will not let you down.
Well, that's right. But but believe me, it's not an easy road. You got to really bust your ass, especially, like I said to you, there's 10,000, over 10,000 kids in Ontario alone that want to be rock stars. Montreal, guaranteed 6,000 to 10,000 people there. Kids on the East Coast, they want to play their acoustic. They want to. They're bred there to play their banjos, acoustics, violins. They are so talented. We are so talented as a nation.
Competition.
Vancouver, the competition is deathly, because there's only limited concert space for places to, for people to play there. So the bands start up, and they never. There are bands there that get going and they sound great, but they can never get on a stage. Because there's not enough clubs, so they go on the road, they head down to Seattle, or they come across Canada to show what the talent they have, they go back there, they can't, there's like 5 major clubs, that's it, you know, for a million people. So how do you play in a city like that, right? So anyhow, there's so much competition out there in this crazy
that's
world.
We drop the lasers on stage too.
Well, that always helps, you know, a little bit of smoke, some lasers, putting together your persona on what you want to people to perceive, whether you're throwing blood or spitting flames or don't set a place on fire. But you know, every band that usually makes it has something that people talk about at the water fountain, using that as a metaphor, form of talk. Where you can go out and you can explain, I saw the most sensational metal band or death metal or soft, whatever your persona of music is. So we were just talking just moments ago while we were listening to the Mudmen about some of the bands that influenced you guys to put your band together, create what you have. And one of them was Hope's Falling.
Hope's Fall.
Hope's Fall. And these guys are from Buffalo.
Right.
So what type of music for song? We'll play one of their songs here, and we'll play some more music that you guys have talked about. What are they like? How do you know of this? What possessed you to play their music?
Well, I guess we were just down in Toronto seeing bands like Monash and Poison the Well, the main bands of hardcore back in the day, 2000. And these guys just happened to play with them one day, and they take this different approach to the heavy style, and they add this really clean, soft acoustic approach to it, where it gives you goosebumps and just lets you just fall into the music. And we've always tried to take that approach, and it seems we've always been a little bit heavier, but we're still bringing it down and softening it up and simplifying our music to be a lot more like Hope's Fall, which I'd say when my brother and I were standing in the crowd, we knew that that's what we wanted to do, like exactly what they were doing on that stage, like just super hitting everybody right to their bone.
Good, you know? Okay, well let's tune into a little bit of their sound here, and live coming to you, that's the button there. There's the button there. We're gonna push this, and come on, you can do it. Yes, you can.
Thank you. listening to Rock Night, only on 100.3 Sound FM. Come back to you. Sing with me. Sing for a year. Sing for the love. Sing for the tear. Sing with me. Just for today. With a tomorrow to be long and take you away.
Well, this is the Road Dog Show. We just want to say you can take your shirt off if you want to. Tune in. We're going to rock it.
And we're back here at the Road Dog Show here at Sound FM. That's 100.3 for all those people that can't count. 1, 2, 3. 100. That's a lot of fingers here, boys and girls. All right. Guys, so we were talking there just a second ago about the Supernova Show. And I know those guys that are, you know, that are promoting or listening right now, they're going to say, you didn't plug us enough, Road Dog. Come on, plug us some more. So let's talk about that show. You guys were there last year.
We were there last year. We've been doing shows with them on and off. And like I said, we threw all the regrouping. This group now, they seem to really like. We seem to sell out with our last show from them. And now they're just throwing shows at us left, right, and center. And
good.
Well, they brought us to you. They are being more than helpful. And yeah, they've got, what, we're co-headlining for the show on Devil's Night.
Devil's Night, boys and girls.
In costumes, and we encourage everybody to dress up and right. See how freaky this crowd can be in all our costumes. And, well, I suggest not wearing big masks because, you know, you won't really see anything coming flying at you.
I will not be coming as a dog, guys.
No?
No.
How about a road? Or a dog that got killed on the road?
Oh.
Roadkill?
Roadkill.
You know, that's a great idea. I'm going to go driving down the highway two nights before and find myself a dead dog in the road, and I'm gonna glue him to my side, okay, and then just paint myself black like a rogue, and with white lines up, you know, and I have a dead dog on my side, and oh god, it'll stink after a while, won't it? And then
Febreze fixes all.
That's terrible. Just
take back on.
Probably, I'm just, you know, me, I probably just, I'll just show up like I'm showing up at every event.
Some tequila parts with our
road, you know. Oh, yeah, don't worry, the dog will have a little tequila in his breath that night. I need a little to help me get by.
Thumbs up.
You guys are great. Got any more of that stuff? So,
just be back ringing.
You never know here on the Road Dog Show. So, okay, so you're, is there a place that, have they already got the placing where you're going to be playing? You're going to be one of the first
the
on?
The second? It's actually the basement of the RBC Financial Building on.
Yeah, right downtown Kitchener. Beautiful place.
Park right beside Elements there.
That big Catholic high school next door. Yep.
Really?
Yeah.
What was there? There used to be St. Mary's.
Oh, is that used to be?
I go to the St. Mary's now. That's what I'm like.
Oh, okay. It used to be. I grew up across the street. My stepdad was the minister at the Zion United across the street, so we just knew it as the Catholic high school.
Now it's down by like the Country Hills area.
Oh, okay, so the always Country Hills now, is it? We're nervous, it's a little higher now.
Where are we coming from?
Okay. You guys look so snobby. Oh,
sure.
You play golf on the weekend, and you're not playing rock and roll. Very good, very good. So, okay.
And what is